Hey everybody, Al Puglisi Trains, part two of Bridge Madness today. Part one was Howard Zane finishing up a beautiful box truss wood bridge that was filmed on the channel. That's part one. I mistakenly said in that video that as an apprentice, I'd never built a bridge with Howard, but that's not true. I'm thinking back, my stupidity. These two bridges, one on my shoulder here and the one behind me, those are Howard Zane viaduct designs that I wanted to replicate on my layout, and Howard has been helping me with these. And that was one of the very first things I did with Howard. I think I started doing that with him before I even became an apprentice working with him. Let me show you, let me give you a closer look at these bridges. They are both a work in progress. Well, this is Big Mama. I don't know what I'm gonna name it. It's a big bridge. Above it is a scene of downtown Ellicott City, St. Paul's Catholic Church and College Avenue. And I know there's not a big viaduct in Ellicott City, Maryland, but it's my artistic license. Again, this is a work in progress. One of the things that I did on this particular bridge, and I'll take a closer look at it, is it's made out of gator board. It's made out of 1/8 inch gator board, and it's actually one big piece. So I cut it from a 8-foot piece of gator foam, and again, it's 1/8 inch thick, and then it was spray painted flat white, and then I took it over Howard's house. And again, it's about 5 feet, and it's about maybe 16 inches tall. And I started to weather, I scribed it with a razor knife and a small screwdriver to put the crack marks and the mortar lines in, kind of like what Howard taught me when he does his concrete and when he does his roads. And then the next thing we did was I weathered one half of the bridge and Howard weathered the other half of the bridge. And we started working from the ends, left end, and the right end to meet in the middle. And the goal was not to be able to tell who did what. And I was very happy to say that after a couple hours worth of work with Howard, the bridge is looking absolutely spectacular. Howard did the side you see here. This is the right side. And I did the left side. And we used some pan pastels to weather this ever so lightly. And whenever I got a little out of control with trying to get a little bit too heavy, Howard reined my ass in and said, okay, back off. And when you use pan pastels, if you watch the video that Howard pastel weathered my diesel engines on, if you overdo it with the pastels, you can use a pencil eraser and you can erase it and redo it. So this has not been sprayed with any type of clear or you know, it hasn't been filmed with, you know, sprayed with any type of clear or flat clear. It is what it is. The color is set. The next step I'm going to do on this bridge is I need to do the inserts. And the way I'm going to do the inserts is, let me show you. Folks, I'm going to go to Hobby Lobby. You can go to Michael's. You can go wherever you want to go. I'm going to use a cardstock. I forget what they call this. It's backing. If you go into the framing section where they sell frames and where they sell framing supplies, mat board, I believe it's called mat board. I call it cardstock. And you can get it 40 thousandths thick. You can get it 80 thousandths thick. You can get different thicknesses of it. And I like getting big sheets like this because what I plan on doing is I plan on measuring the width of the arch. If the width of the arch I need is, let's say, 7 inches, 6 inches, I will cut a long strip vertically, 6 inches wide or whatever measurement I need wide, right down the center. And I've got a nice 3.5 foot long section. And I can easily bend it without any problem right around the corner to form an arch. And then it can be simply glued in place with contact cement or goo. Believe it or not, goo works very well. And the reason, again, I like using this is because it is very flexible and it can easily be made into whatever size arch you may need. And then you can use goo or whatever type of cement. You can mask it off and let it dry overnight, whatever you want to do. Now, what else I will do is scribe it. I will take a razor knife and I will, of course, mark out the width and then make the sections, maybe 10 foot across. And then I will scribe in lightly, not heavily, but lightly, some of the cracks and weather it so it would be painted and weathered and pasteled before I go to glue it in. Now, I'll make another video as things progress. This is a work in progress. So I have not started it yet, but when I do, I'll have an update video and perhaps I'll have the sections so that you can watch and follow more closely. Now, blocks of balsa wood can be put in here, glued in, or strips of balsa can be glued in, maybe quarter inch strips, so that it gives something to attach to. When I take the cardstock that will be cut, I can bend it and I can tape it in and I can mask it off temporarily and let it dry overnight. And I can match my joints running across to the bridges, joints going across, and I can match the color. That won't be a problem. So that'll be the arch inserts. Now, what else am I going to do? I'm going to have LED light. Howard has LED lights raining down from the center of each arch, raining down on the layout, and it really adds a really interesting look. And what I plan on doing is I'll run LED lights across the bridge and cut openings in the top of the arch so that the light can shine through as I insert each arch. Now, again, when you do this, you have to make absolutely sure that the outer arch on both sides is exactly the same size and are lined up in exactly the same place. Otherwise, things aren't going to match up. So it's a little bit flexible here, left and right. Each one of these, the outer arch wall here, is exactly the same as the arch wall on the other side. All you need to do is true them up, and then you can use the cardstock, or you can use sheets of styrene. The only reason I'm not using styrene sheets is they're astronomically expensive. Styrene sheets used to be $5, $6 each, and good God, a styrene sheet big enough to do an arch run every bit of 20 bucks a sheet. So I'm going to use the cardstock. And let me again show you the type of balsa I'll be bracing it with. Well, here's a balsa stick. Howard uses a lot of these sticks. You can get them on Amazon. They're about, I don't know, 3/8 thick, maybe 3/4, quarter inch. But you can buy them in strips. You can use basswood, you can use balsa, and you can cut them. And you can glue them in on the inside. And that gives more of a space, more surface for the arch to be glued to. And again, they can be masking taped on the edges with goo or whatever type of cement you want to use. I like goo. That way, if there's any problem, anything needs to be shifted, it can be shifted. And then overnight, it'll be dry and it won't be going anywhere. Here's an old picture of me over at Howard's house. This is Maisie's Falls. And when I saw this viaduct at Maisie Falls, I said, man, I've got to do something like this on my layout. This is absolutely fantastic. And again, Howard has graciously allowed me to use this as a basis for my bridge, one of his designs. And you can see the insert arches on this bridge, just like I was talking. And I even left the space at the end of the bridge if I wanted to put some type of signal tower or traffic tower in there, I could do it, but I don't think I'm going to do it because it may make my scene look a bit too busy. I don't have the vast open space Howard has. Again, once that's done and the arches have been inserted and I use the neon lights in the center of each arch, I think this bridge will look incredibly impressive. There's a highway on top of this bridge, and you can use Rick's products or various different products for the guards running across the bridge. The highway is still a work in progress going across the bridge, so it's a two-lane road plus the railroad bridge, and you can see that I have not secured down this big piece of gator foam yet. It's in the process of being a work in progress. Let me show you some other bridges on the layout. Well, here's another bridge. Again, it's a viaduct type bridge, and same principle on this bridge. It's a piece of eighth inch gator board that I cut, scribed 10 foot blocks out of, or whatever, 20 foot. I can't remember what the spacing on the blocks is. It might be 20 feet. And of course, they've been scribed with a knife, and they've been capped with a proper capping material that needs to be run, which styrene sheets from Plastruck strips can be used as caps. And then I will do the same exact thing on this bridge. The inserts need to be made, and I'm going to do the inserts the exact same way, lining up the bridge, making sure both outer walls are exactly the same, and then doing it. I have a third bridge. Let me show you. A third bridge goes here. This is a work in progress, just like the other two. This one's nowhere near as far along. And you can see it's a piece of gator foam. And I've got the strip that I will cap on the top, styrene. And I've done my spacing with a pencil. And then I will scribe with a X-Acto blade or a small screwdriver or dental tool to open up scribes just big enough so that when they're weathered, it catches the material. And I'll take a X-Acto knife and I'll make my cracks and stress cracks. But one thing here, I might not do this one the same as the others. I may do this one as a stone bridge, or I may do this one as a brick bridge. I haven't made up my mind if I'm going to keep this in line with the other two bridges and make it concrete, or if I'm going to make it stone, or if I'm going to make it brick. But that's the fun of the hobby, the just waiting to decide what I want to do. Well, end this Bridge Madness video with, this is the backside of the town of Winston, and there is a large opening here between where the logging line abruptly comes to a stop and where the logging line on the opposite side is going to reconnect, and then the main line will, I should say the logging line will head down into the town of Winston and attach the town of Winston to the rest of the layout. And I've always wanted to build a huge timber trestle, and that's what's going to be in here. It's going to be a big timber trestle that's going to fill in this gap between that end and that end, and I think it'd be pretty impressive once it's done. And that's, again, it's going to be a while before I get in the mood to do that, but once I start that project, that will also be on the channel. Folks, thanks for watching, and if you like what you see, please hit the subscribe button, and please hit that like button, because the more people that like the videos and the more people that subscribe, the more YouTube is going to push this channel out. Thanks so much for watching.